Hey, horse people. She's like, oh shit, he's got the camera on. Man, we had the first rain last night in freaking, I don't know how long. My pond is so low. It's just crazy. So I'm out here. After a rain, I like to just fluff up my guy's hair. It has to be dry enough. You notice right here on Mr. T, he's still a little wet. So it didn't brush out, but all this is pretty dry. And you can see this side that's been brushed. Buddy doesn't get that long hair, so he doesn't mat down a whole bunch, but I already brushed him anyway. But as I'm brushing him, I figured I'd do the other side. And notice the big difference in his hair is matted down. He's been laying in the grass. Is that gonna hurt him? No. Is that gonna be a problem? No. I just tend to fluff up his hair. You notice underneath hair, it's fluffy. And then he has the wet drip marks here. So I like to just brush him out and fluff him up, make him look nice. Lets him warm up good. Lets him his hair and the wind blow through it. Here comes Mrs. Cow coming in to get something to eat. Buddy's holding my brush. Thanks, buddy. Dad got tired of holding the brush. I know. So, again, Buddy's got that shorter hair. He's got that thicker undercoat. So he stays warm different than Mr. T. Mr. T gets that long, fluffy hair. And, of course, they're both got their little head in here eating their little... They got to eat the bottom. I break up the alfalfa and put it there, so they have to eat all the little nuggets at the bottom. And then push all the other stuff on the outside. Then they'll come clean all this up. So that's some what they call coastal or... hell, I can't think of the other word they call it around here. I don't know. It's not coming to me. And then that's alfalfa. And the vet gave him a good bill of health. See, Mr. T? Mr. T, this is his wild side. See, Mr. T's multi-coated. He's got his wild side that's matted and dirty and hay. And then you come around to his other side and he's got his nice, soft, lovable, little good boy side that's been groomed. Now, is this grooming necessary? Look, I can feel that he's a little damp underneath, but if it was still raining, I wouldn't mess up that drip line. I talk about that natural drip line. He doesn't have a drip line over here because his fur. So if it starts raining right now, he's going to have to get wet enough to beat off the water, and then it'll cause these drip lines, which will come down right here. If you notice on this side, he does have his drip lines. See how all his fur has a good, it's gone down his back and it's come down the sides. So he's got a good drip line here, which means his undercoat is dry, and he's just got that. And then the drip line ends about right here, so his belly always stays nice and fluffy. I didn't groom his belly, so it keeps him warm, and the drip line will usually start about right here. So I wouldn't want to mess up this natural drip line if he was wet and it was still raining, because that's actually a protection. So, you know, leaving him alone when it's raining is one thing, but we're not expecting any more rain, and, you know, I just came out here, like I said, I saw him kind of matted down. I'm going to brush down this side too. When I was brushing down this side, I thought I could give you a good contrast of what the grooming does, how it fluffs up the hair. It allows him to stay warmer. Is he warmer on this side than the other side? Maybe a little bit. The other side's still kind of damp, and it's not giving him as good as even protection because he's been groomed through here. And you can... It's not really a groom line, but down here where he's still wet when I groom, it just kind of mats it down. It stays wet right there. See how it doesn't fluff up? So if his whole body was like this, I wouldn't want to be grooming him. But if you groom him and it dries like this, and I'll go to the other side. Mr. T's like, dude, shut up and let me eat my... So on this side, I'll just do one right down the middle here. So now you see how the fur is kind of, it's spread out, it's fluffy, it's giving him more coverage. So is he a little cooler here than here? If it was really cold out and he had this, I always come out and brush him when it's really cold because I want this fluffy hair. So his thermal regulation, you can look that up on my site. I have a couple good articles on it. Understanding why blankets aren't good for horses. This is almost like a little blanket and it keeps their hair matted down. And they can't get this fluffy thermal regulation to where they can contract their skin and fluff their hair up and gather air underneath there. So you can tell the difference of that one groom spot, especially as I back away. Not only does it change colors, but it just makes his hair a little, you know, again, not so matted down. This is almost a matted, which is what a blanket and covering and all that other crap does a horse. It doesn't allow him to cool. This, if he gets too hot, he can cool off. This, if he gets too cold, it's going to be harder for him to warm up because he can't move his hair like here. So anyway, let me get another little strip down his butt here. That little strip looked pretty good on that one video. Yeah, see, it doesn't show up quite as good on his butt, that one straight down. But you can tell matted from that. Anyway, just thought it was kind of, hi, Mr. Donkey. He's like, what up, dude? Hi, Mrs. Cow. Where's your other little cow friend? She's been moving really slow. She's way out there. All right. Well, that's horsey watch in the morning after the big rain. Watching the boys eating and talking about their fur. Let me finish grooming Mr. T. We'll end that there. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys. Donkey, don't be playing the banjo on that fence line. Play me a tune, Mr. Donkey. You reach up and grab that thing and go, twing. All right, we'll end that there.